Hey everyone, so this is my second video. This one is more about the firewall in security. And just first, before everything, if you want to go deeper on this level, and actually, I think there's a great video out there which is much better than everything I could do. This is basically a video on the same topic from Lawrence System, and I'm going to give you the link obviously in the description. But otherwise, here we go. So I'm going to go on security, and first I'm going to migrate to this new firewall zone system. And I said before, but it can be very overwhelming and a bit scary at the first place. But when you get used to it, it's very straightforward, easy to understand. And as long as you have a backup, you can still go back. I know it's not that easy in production, but anyway, we're going to start by doing a trust zone. So I'm going to put my secure VLAN inside here, which is basically my trust device, which is basically Apple device. So all my Macs, MacBook Pro, iPad, Apple TV, everything, even HomePod are in there. Device that I trust 100%. Well, actually, no, wrong. And you should never trust anything 100%. Just FYI. So now, if you check this matrix now and trust toward trust, we should see that everything is blocked by default. So you can see there, block all traffic. And we want to actually allow this traffic inside the zone. For instance, for example, let's say you want to maybe AirPlay something to your Apple TV or to your HomePod or whatever. We can because we trust this device by definition. So that's fine. That's not going to be outside the zone. That's going to stay inside the zone, and that's fine. So trust is a source and destination is also the source because we are in this segment here, and we're gonna click allow, and we're gonna leave everything as is, and we have a zone now, so we're good. And next we're gonna block IoT stuff. So basically we want to be able to go to IoT, but we don't want IoT to come to us. So for trust to IoT, we can allow the traffic. So for instance, I have, for example, a VM with Home Assistant, and I want to be able to control it and to access everything. But I don't want anything from my IoT to go back here to my trust device because IoT is not safe 100%. Just so you know, in 2023, there was 400% increase of hack from IoT device, just to let you know. So we have a block, we have a allow within trust, and we have a trust toward IoT. So this is all good. And I'm not just saying that, I'm just going to show you at the end of this video how to test everything to make sure everything is all right or not. So now I have also all of these things, which is a bit more scary. And actually, I would like your feedback on this, but is all my allows rules is going from the external to my gateway, which is for IPv6. It's not everything, it's basically ICMP. So if I show you where we're gonna create the first policy now, which is what is from external to the gateway, and we're gonna call it let's say I'm just gonna copy the one from my dream machine. Oh, sorry, actually, from my cloud gateway fiber. Need to get used to this one. Anyway, so allow and down there, you should see custom for protocol. And then we can select ICMPv6. Although my is gray out, which is normal because, silly me, I just select both for IP, so IPv4 and IPv6. Obviously, we only want IPv6 for ICMPv6. So we're just gonna select IPv6 and then allow again for the action, and going down to protocol, we're gonna go to custom and ICMPv6. And we're gonna allow all these rules that you can see on the background here. There's a few ones. So this one is for packet too big. And this is limited to ICMP v6. That's not fine. We're gonna add a new one now for time exceed. Same is allow. Like, I don't know for you, but I'm a bit scared about IPv6, but at the same time, I'm very excited about it. That's a scary bit because I should be only scary, but I'm not. Anyway, so if we go down where we can select this time exceed and we're good. I might just go fast forward all the rest because there's quite a few on, but feel free to stop if you want. No, going back to security, we also have some single app category blocks. So for instance, we could block SSH or more likely business tool. We can do that from one device or for the whole network. So let's say we want to block IoT. Or let's say we actually want to block the IoT network and the LAN, which is my default air. So we're going to select all this. And then, well, you can select a specific app and select there, but we're going to go in category and, for example, business tool there for SSH. But for instance, we can imagine peer-to-peer could be blocked and file transfer, for instance. Just an example, you can do whatever you want for a certain device. And they also have DNS server, which is not a DNS server, it's basically a block rule that's going to forward everything is not in air to a DNS server, so the one you select before, and it's going to block all the ads. So that's kind of good, but then not as good, obviously, of Firewall or maybe AdWord Home and stuff like this, or even Nextcloud. So I will do a video on this in a day sometime, but you can do that in UniFi as well. Although it's not that, I mean, you don't have a lot of control on it. And you can also block some geo, so you can see where you have block. You can go incoming, outgoing, or both. So I guess I would recommend incoming only. But I'm not going to show you the list there because I don't want to make some people angry about the country I'm selecting there. It's up to you. You can do that. You have the option, so feel free to do it. It might block some traffic, so be careful. Like, for example, if, say, you put both directions and you try to go to AliExpress and you block China, you might have some issue. Something which is very cool, though, is we finally have encrypted DNS. So by default and by design, it's very easy to know what URL you're browsing. So if somebody on the same network, especially, he can basically see everything, and that's not even an hack, that's very straightforward. But by using an encrypted DNS, you're gonna hide this traffic, and it's gonna be much harder to decrypt all this. Near impossible, actually. So you have a list there of different provider. I'm gonna use Quad9, and you have IPv4, IPv6, GOH or GOT. So GOH is the DNS over HTTPS, and GOT DNS over TTS. And you have other options there. You also have some filter if you want. So let's say a family and adult website, or like malware and stuff like this. And you can select a few one as well. So that's kind of cool to have that there in UniFi. That was add, I think, a few updates back, but for a while we don't have anything like this, so I'm glad to have it. You also can create a honeypot. So basically you're gonna open some security issue, well, fake security issue, and try to spot some people who try to connect there. I guess it's a bit more complicated to understand, so that's rare if you need to use it. But the one thing I won't use every time is IPS. So it's basically gonna notify you or notify and block, which I always select. So it's gonna block every threat that you can come across, or every security threat. And when I say every, actually, it's only the one in the signature. So you can add that with the 89 euro without tax. So it's actually a bit more. But it's actually quite decent by default anyway. Let's go back to the security, actually the firewall zone setting from earlier. So I'm connected on 172.16.0.11, and I'm gonna try to reach Home Assistant in 192.168.3.230. So if I ping a 192.168.3.230, I can see it's work, no issue. So I'm on this VLAN now, but if I go inside my IoT, so I'm gonna connect to the right Wi-Fi, which is IoT, very straightforward. then I should be blocked when I try to connect something the other way in my trust zone. So let's say I can maybe try to reach my Apple TV, which is on my trust zone. So the IP is there. And technically, it should be blocked as we block IoT toward trust. So we're going to check that now. So first, I'm just double check. You can clear if you want to remove everything on the screen, but it's fine for now. So I'm on 192.168.3.210, and if I try 172.16.0.37, it's actually not reaching anything. So 100% packet lost. And if I try Proxmost, it's exactly the same thing. So that's it for this video. See you next one, and have a good one. Bye.